I'd like to start by thanking Judge To'oto'o for having me today. None of this has been in my control, and by allowing me to come and say the things I've needed to say for the past 9 months gives me a small sense of closure. To give some context as to where I was at in my life when this all began, I was newly engaged, 2 days to be exact, and awaiting a celebration with my dad and new fiance on Maui. On the morning of June 10th, my fiance and I were packing to attend a dear friend's wedding on Kauai, which we never made it to, when my aunt called to tell me that my father was in the ICU at Queens Medical. I thought I had heard her wrong, or that they had identified the wrong person. Surely this was a mistake. Mr. Coleman, you took the happiest event of my life and quickly turned it into a nightmare. You have now robbed me of the chance to walk down the aisle with my father on my wedding day, of the beautiful father-daughter dance any little girl envisions, many birthdays and Father's Days, the chance to see my dad turn into a granddad, and the simple joys of hearing his voice on a bad day. But more importantly, you robbed me of my chance to say a proper goodbye, to tell him all the things I needed to say to him, and to hear everything he would have told me before he left this earth. Because of you, I have many unanswered questions, ones I will unfortunately never get the answers to. My dad was one of the most positive, loving men I've ever met. His optimism growing up would often annoy me because the realist in me said, it can't be our year every year, but that was his saying. And looking back, I realized I needed a little more of that in my life. He never lacked affection, and his joyful attitude were just a few of the things that many remember about him. He had the ability to make everyone feel special. He was a dreamer and taught me to never give up on mine. Many things were said in the media about my father over the course of this, a lot of which were untrue. My dad has never been a violent man, and while he struggled with addiction, he was never a thief. I didn't understand the whys of a lot of things my dad did growing up. After his passing, I've learned a great deal about his childhood and the traumas he faced as a young boy. I can only imagine the traumas you must have faced, Mr. Coleman, which led to the reason behind you sitting here today. With all that being said, we live in a world full of hatred and negativity, and I refuse to share a part in that. So I came here today to tell you, just like I told my father before he took his last breath, that I forgive you. From the bottom of my heart, I forgive you. Lastly, to any parent facing an addiction who is too ashamed to seek help or thinks their relationships are beyond repair, to any parent who is depressed and feels like they can overcome it on their own, I beg you to think again, because after everything my father put me through, I would do anything to have him here again. Mahalo.
Yes, Your Honor, I'd just like to say to the family of the victim, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, this wasn't supposed to happen. It wasn't supposed to happen like this. I'm just so sorry. My prayers go out to his family, and it's really coming from my heart. I've never had to deal with nothing this serious. I'm so sorry. And I've been battling drug addiction for almost 40 years. I'll be 60 years old, and I relapsed after 15 years of being clean. I just wish that this wouldn't have happened. And once again, I just send my prayers out to Mr. Nolan's family, and I'm so sorry. And I just hope for a chance to get my life back together and take care of my addiction and in my problems. I'd like to thank the court also for giving my day. And thank you too, Your Honor.
Okay, all right, before we get into the sentencing part,